Ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming the next Prime Minister of Australia, Tony Abbott.
Andrew, thank you so much. It's terrific to be here. It's terrific to see you. Whenever I see you, even if it's at 4:45 a.m. in the morning on a bike ride, look, this man has served his country with distinction the whole of his life. This man spent some 30 years in uniform, serving our country at home and abroad, and it makes me so proud of Australia and so proud of our party that we have a man of this calibre who now wants to serve his country in the Parliament. Andrew Nikolic was actually the first person to be endorsed for our party, the first candidate to be endorsed for our party for the 2013 election. Back in early 2011, he was endorsed to run in this election. He was the original, and even though we've got a lot of very good candidates running right around this wide brown land, I've got to say, of Andrew, I say, he is the original and the best. Many, many times as leader of our great party. I've been to Tasmania many, many times since entering the Parliament almost 20 years ago. This is a great state. You are a great people. You know, I know, that you have been held back by bad Labor Green governments, first in Hobart and more recently in Canberra. And a recovery for Tasmania starts with getting rid of the bad Labor Green government in Canberra and then getting rid of the bad Labor Green government in Hobart. I regret to say that after an economic spurt under the Howard government, Tasmania has gone backwards. It's particularly gone backwards over the last 5 years. There's a sense in which, though, Tasmania has been a laboratory for what Australia would look like if this Labor Green government is to continue, is to get another 3 years at the coming election. And what does Tasmania look like? Notwithstanding a great and creative people, notwithstanding a beautiful natural environment, notwithstanding so much going for it, right now Tasmania has the highest unemployment in our nation, it has the lowest average weekly earnings in our nation, and has the lowest life expectancy in our nation. I say that must change, and change begins with changing the government in Canberra. Yeah. You know better than anyone else in Australia just what Labor Green government is like. It's always the same. Labor Green government means taxes go up, regulation goes up, economic activity goes down, and unemployment goes up. That's what always happens. And if the Labor Green government is re-elected in Canberra, what we will see is higher taxes, more regulation, bigger government, and less prosperity for every one of us. That's the last thing we need. The last thing we need is another 3 years like the last six. It's the last thing our country needs. I want to assure you that the coalition that I lead, the strong united team that I lead, has positive plans for a better future. And a better future starts with our plans for a stronger economy. That's what I have been talking about over the last few days as this campaign has gone into full swing. I have been talking about our plans for a better life for every one of you. We'll take off the carbon tax, not reduce it, not rebadge it. We will eliminate the carbon tax, because eliminating the carbon tax means less pressure on your cost of living. It means less pressure on your job security. Yesterday, I announced a reduction in the company tax rate, because that means more investment and more jobs. Julia Gillard herself said early last year, if you are against cutting the company tax rate, you are against jobs. Well, I'm in favour of jobs, and that's why under the coalition, but only under the coalition, there will be a reduction in the company tax rate. We will reduce red tape. Red tape costs on business by $1 billion a year. Because doesn't everyone know that there is just far too much interference in your life, particularly interference in your commercial life? But as well as having a plan for Australia, I have a plan for Tasmania. And doesn't Tasmania need some positive plans at a time like this? Our plan for Tasmania starts with upgrading the Midland Highway. It is the backbone of Tasmania, and you need a strong backbone if you are going to have a strong economy. So we upgrade the Midland Highway. We make Tasmania the focus of all of Australia's Antarctic operations. We absolutely keep the freight equalisation scheme that the Coalition first put in place some 30 years ago. We absolutely protect Tasmania's share of revenues coming from the Commonwealth, particularly the GST. But what we do, which this government in Hobart and that government in Canberra just don't understand, if there is federal money to be spent here in Tasmania, you don't spend it closing industries down, you spend it keeping industries open. I say to the people of Tasmania, your forestry industry should be part of a clean, green future. I say to the people of Tasmania that your fishing industry and your aquaculture industry should be part of a clean, green future. We will not lock up our forests and we will not lock up our oceans. Tasmania needs to be an economy as well as a national park. Finally, I want to say to you, my friends, that it is always good to be in Tasmania and to see the state leader of our party, Will Hodgman. Will Hodgman is an absolutely outstanding Tasmanian and a great Australian. He has laboured long and hard to make this state great, and he is labouring long and hard to build up our country. Will and I speak very frequently. Will and I know that Tasmania needs special attention. Will and I know that Tasmania really needs to be made a special economic zone, because we have got to lift this state from being one of the economic also-rans to being an economic powerhouse in our nation. I'll be spending the morning and most of the day here in Tasmania with Will. We're going to have more to say about what we are going to do to lift this state out of the economic morass that Labor Green government has plunged it into. And it all starts with jobs. It all starts with jobs. And I am looking forward to spending time with Will, to spending time with you, to spending time with the people of Tasmania and making sure that as time goes by, more and more of them are employed in the best possible jobs. Ladies and gentlemen. You all know the kind of state Tasmania can be. You all know the kind of country that we can be. You all know that after the last few years, we are not everything we could be. We could be so much better than this, and being our best selves, being better than this, starts with changing the government. Now I know that this election is going to turn more on the last 6 years of bad government than it is on the next 30 days of the campaign. But I also know that everyone in this room is going to lift himself or herself to new heights of energy and activism over the next 30 days. We are ready to govern. We are worthy of government. We won't let this state, we won't let this country down. Thank you.